gathered here today to celebrate our graduation from high school. I ask that you would watch over us and lead us to make the right decisions in the years ahead. Thank you for the wonderful teachers and supportive families that you have blessed us with. I pray that those here tonight will always put their faith and trust in you no matter where life takes us. Lord, let our years ahead be filled with happiness and success. In your name I pray. Amen. Amen. You may be seated.
Yeah. your parents, family, teachers, administrators, and fellow graduates. Hey, y'all. I would like to extend my personal welcome to the 2016 8th grade graduation. It has been a great privilege for me and for all of us to have attended Hearts Bluff to be a part of such an amazing community. The 2016 graduation class has been through some pretty awesome experiences, like going to NASA or going to visit the Alamo. But we've been through some pretty terrible times, like think through math. Hearts Bluff is like a family to me and probably all of you. Hearts Bluff has helped shape us into the heroes of our own story. And today marks a bittersweet day as our Hearts Bluff chapter ends. In this past year, I have been followed around by a group of little munchkins. If you haven't guessed yet, I'm a pal. But having little kids follow you around isn't necessarily a bad thing. I have learned several valuable life lessons in the class. For one thing, kids are hard, but they're kind of cute. I have also learned a ton of responsibility and integrity being in the class. The kids have taught me to do what is right no matter how boring it might be. A child may be struggling while having to do his or her work while the other children are playing outside or doing a fun activity. And no matter how much you want to do their work for them, you have to let them accomplish it themselves so they can gain the fundamental foundations of their education. Kindergartners might also want to do something that might seem fun to them, but is actually quite dangerous, like climbing on top of a slide to catch ladybugs. You have to do the right thing and be the better person for their own well-being. Most importantly, the kindergartners have taught me that the teachers have always been looking out for us, no matter how aggravating we might have been. This year at Hearts Bluff, they finished a new addition to the school. This new building is equipped with rolly chairs, colorful furniture, and giant computer TVs. This isn't close to what classrooms looked like last year. These changes have seemed dramatic to the way we're used to things, but it's not going to be anything compared to high school. I mean, we walk like 2 feet to go to our next class. Bradley Whitford once said, "Take action. Every story you've ever connected with, every leader you've ever admired, every puny thing you've ever accomplished is a result of taking action. You have a choice. You can either be a passive victim of circumstance, or you can be the active hero of your own life." As we close the school year and our paths divide, we must remember that Hearts Bluff has given us the foundation and the strength of character to become the heroes of our own individual stories. Hearts Bluff has given us so many unique opportunities that not all the students at other schools get to experience. We got the ability to mature in such a safe, replaceable environment. We got the ability to become such close friends with our peers. Now, as we leave Hearts Bluff, we aren't just saying goodbye to some school, teachers, and random classmates. We're saying goodbye to our home and our family. As we step out of the well-known world of childhood and step into a brand new world of young adulthood, which we have barely gotten a glimpse of, you'll have to remember to be brave. Brave to make decisions that will lead on to the journey of the rest of our lives. But this isn't going to be easy. We're going to be faced with distractions and difficulties. We're going to need to be confident in our actions, do what you believe. Robert Frost took the road that traveled by, and that made all the difference for him. So it isn't always best to follow the crowd. If you have faith in something, but others tease or make fun of you for it, all I can say about that is the haters are going to hate, so you do you, boo. In the end, Hearts Bluff has helped create some really great people throughout the years. However, there have been several important people that have got us to where we are today, and I would like to thank them. Thank you to anyone that has ever helped us, believed in us, made us who we are. Thank you to families who sacrificed basically everything for us. Thank you for putting up with us, feeding us, giving us shelter, and loving us. Thank you, teachers, for going above and beyond to make us succeed. Thank you for not just teaching us, but for being there for us. Thank you to everyone that's in the audience for caring for at least one of us enough to come out tonight. To the class of 2016, thank you for the memories and remember to be the hero of your own story. Remember to challenge yourself to take the best path, the one you want to do. Remember, you can accomplish anything if you set your mind to it. You just have to have the initiative to do so. Remember to be courageous no matter how difficult the circumstance may be. And lastly, remember to be brave and challenge yourself to be great.
the 2016 Hearts Bluff graduation. On behalf of the 2016 graduating class, I would like to take the time to thank the people who have made this evening possible. First of all, I would like to thank our family and friends. It is our family that shows us the love and support that we need to succeed in school. I would also like to thank my own family for pushing me to do my best and helping me to attain my goals. Next, I would like to thank all of our teachers. You have done so much for us to get us this far. You come to work each day, even when you may not always want to be here, just to make it possible for us to excel. So, today marks the end of our Hearts Bluff experience. Dr. Seuss said, "Don't cry because it's over, smile because it happened." Even though some of y'all are excited to leave, I'm kind of sad about it. But we have all had some great memories here together, whether you've been here for 9 years or even just one. My memories of Hearts Bluff span all the way from kindergarten. It's hard to put all that down into a few sentences, but there are a few great times that stick out in my memory. I remember Ms. Brown teaching us the basics and the importance of a good nap. The time someone was tied up to a pole on the playground. The times we stayed after school with Ms. Sanford to just talk and chill. The school trips to San Antonio and NASA were educational but fun, and a time for bonding, even if Jonathan's worksheets wanted to make you cry. Doing things like band, archery, and volleyball. It has been an honor to be on student council and NJHS. I will not forget how much these times have meant to me and how much it has made me grow. Hearts Bluff will always be where it all started. Now as we are moving on to high school, we will have new adventures and new memories to make. While some of us will be moving on together, others will be going away and going on their own paths. No matter where we all go, the next 4 years will be full of opportunities. These opportunities will provide a foundation for our education and our future professions. As Henry David Thoreau once said, "Go confidently in the direction of your dreams. Live the life you have imagined." It is also important to remember that as stressful as things may become, but these next 4 years are also supposed to be fun. It is a time for us to enjoy activities and become more active in the community. We will make decisions that will affect our future. Together we will grow and mature to become the leaders of tomorrow. To use a quote from my dad's valedictorian speech, Shakespeare once wrote, "All the world is a stage and the men and women merely players." So as we move on to high school, we will begin to take on our roles on the world stage. We will leave our roles as Hearts Bluff students and use our experience as the foundation for a journey in the greatest play called life. Thank you all again for coming out tonight and being a part of this journey. Good night.
ISD. They fulfilled all requirements set forth by the state of Texas and the school district to be called graduates of this school. Their teachers, Hearts Bluff administration, parents, family and friends, and members of our community have prepared them well for the next step of their education. While they are leaving Hearts Bluff ISD, they will always be part of this school community. If the first of the graduates would please rise. Abigail Christine Mason, valedictorian. Shelby Victoria Courageous, salutatorian. Natalie Brooke Howard. Caroline Grace Rose. Miller. Caroline Louise Blackard. Sari Martinez. And finish it. Jordan Bradford Young. Ariel Paige Parr. Madison Ray Antum. Ashley Joe Finishek. Tammy Lynn Carter. McKenna Lee Cornelius. Bailey Dean Craig. Caden Daniel Crooks. Tanner Cash Easley. Ty Era Finley. Fatima Fuentes. Janet Garcia Hernandez. James Russell Hedges. Presley Ann Hunter. Aldo Jimenez. Nicholas David Mankin. Megan Lee Miller. Alice Faye Moon. Rayondo Axel Moreno. Yvonne Joffrey Ojendez Garcia. Karen Diane Ortiz. Savannah Nicole Paleco. Angel Quiroga. Sebastian Salvador.
Sometimes you gotta know these things fall through.
But I'm still tired, I can't hide, I can't shake it down.